Cody, yeah.
Did you just not say it was in Dudley's favour?
No, I've never said that.
I think it's like 0.5 Dudley just because...
In Dudley's favour? You think it's in Dudley's favour?
We play the exact same game.
Yeah.
He just gets... He gets a bit more and he's got...
But you control the space a lot more.
Yeah, but that's what we're playing. We're playing that exact same game, the Whiff Punish game. But it's just like he's got the corner carry.
Yeah.
And he's also got the... If I can't just block him out. He kind of like blocked me out.
Yeah.
I can't just block him out because he's got the overhead and the low.
You got an overhead.
Yeah.
It's just like
combos into
800 frame startup.
Yeah. And 100 damage. That's it. But yeah, it's just I would 0.5 just because yeah, basically played the exact same game. He just got a better option because I can't just block him up because he's got the overhead option.
I think you can keep him out though a lot easier than definitely, he can keep
definitely,
you out.
Definitely.
Alright, so we got Jordan up against Affy. Dry ass games, but he's in the corner. Doesn't wake up with jab,
Poison
doesn't wake up with the DP.
Against, Fei Long as well.
Yeah?
Yep.
Why is
she
this?
She got the normals to punish his wreckers.
Oh, nice. He actually gets in.
Yeah, and that should never happen.
Chicken. Oh, just follows up. Just ran out of armor.
Yep. Nice. I like to stand heavy punch just to say stop walking forward, mate. Nice.
Guaranteed
punish. KO. He was so ready. Third one or not, mate. First
round. So if you've got an ultra that punishes, just be ready for that.
Yeah, I wasn't ready.
If you're not going to go and try and punish the first one, just be ready for your max ultra punish.
And you just saw that her focus kind of brings her back. The wreck actually missed and he punished the recovery. Nice. Oh.
Oh, no. Good.
Oh, nice neutral jump from Jordan. But yeah, Poison's focus brings her back. So she kind of, if she focuses preemptively, she kind of gets out of the range of the wrecker.
Yeah.
And then she'll punish the actual whiff.
Nice.
Nice again. I would have liked to have seen a raw
what
ultra.
Was that, man? Anything other than that.
Yeah.
But you dropped a few punishes as well today.
I dropped quite a bit, yeah.
What was that? Okay. Interesting, Affy.
I think he just tried it out. Nice.
Why was that you were dropping stuff today? It's weird.
Oh no, it's just occasional drops.
You're just getting like a normal and nothing.
No. There was one time against Islam where I did a normal and I didn't want to do anything. After the red focus, I did normal and I did stand fierce. That was the reset because I knew they wouldn't do any damage with the red focus. But there was a few times where I just missed my combos. I would like to see stand medium, but nice. After going crazy, I'm blocking you.
Is it or?
Yeah.
Actually, I'm blocking it.
Yep. You have to do something to get out of it.
Nice.
Well, I believe it is. Okay,
I'm glad they fixed that in this game. Nice. Converts off the trade.
Nice. And that fireball was so slow, but he just wasn't ready. He just got hit and he was like, what do I do?
Oh. What's the football score, please? Anyone know? Let me know.
Nice. Hit confirmed. Fei Long can punish the wrecker. There we go. He backdash and that's what happens. And again, so Whiff punish the wrecker because she goes out of range. I'm not alright. I'm blown on my right. No, oh, what a bait. Stun incoming. That was rude.
Perfect.
You didn't have
it's
to
a
do
flawless
that.
Victory.
That was flawless, mate. But them.
Dre, man, you need to walk to your toy. Can I get the charger, please?
Nice game from Affy. He's 2-0 up now. Very, very good play. And that is something that doesn't work.
2-0 Arsenal, for real. Yeah. Arsenal really winning 2-0. Am I getting trolled?
Good punish from Jordan. 3 frames. That's a minus 4 move. Comps. Can you get my bag, please? My charger's in there. And again, you're seeing it. You can't do anything about that. You have to. Chicken wing can maybe get you out of there.
Yeah.
But that's about it. You can't do it. If you backdash, you can get hit on recovery. If you do that, you get hit. If you do a flame kick.
He recovers before you, even though it's got a lot of recovery.
Yep.
Not as much.
My back. Oh, safety. Missed the punish this time. Unlucky. Oh, that's where my cream is. Yeah, damn. Look at this guy.
Nice pressure there from Jordan.
Gets around finally.
Looking to put a game on the.
Hello?
On the board.
Yep. Nice anti air. Yeah. Damage isn't amazing. Damage isn't amazing, but the anti air is the anti air. Nice anti air. And I'm not sure about that jab hit, she's passing that. Nice hit confirmed from Jordan.
Hit again, and he's waking up with jab. That time he wakes up with a DP.
Oh, he didn't let it go fast enough, this time. And he's still doing it, and there's no reason to stop. It's a very viable, very good option.
Jab with, got thrown.
Very good option. Oh, he could anti-air there. Nice.
Oh, nice. Tags it on.
Nice juggle.
On the end.
Don't know why I was expecting an ultra there. That was a bad overhead.
Hello, can you hear me? Nice. No, not really nice. Actually, got one hit. That's pretty.
He wanted to be guaranteed, but I don't think that was what he wanted to do.
No.
It definitely wasn't the best punishment. Got like 10 damage. Nice up select, but because of her backdash, she just flies out in the air.
She does have a 3-frame jab.
Yes.
That is why she is spamming the hell out of it. The thing with Afi is he basically either
Did
reversals or she recovered.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The thing with Afi is he's either reversals or jabs, so it's like...
But what are you going to do about that? If he doesn't, he can focus backdash as well.
Yeah.
So you can't even delay anything.
So like...
Nice.
If you delay crouch tech because you think it's going to reversal, you'll get hit by the jab.
Yep.
If you try and do something, he'll do a reversal. Yep. So like.
And if you don't do anything, she backdashes. Nice.
Surprisingly effective. Especially like when you have a character that... Yeah, takes it.
Well done.
3-0. Especially when you've got a character that like dominates the neutral game.
I agree. Well, he doesn't dominate the neutral game. Not in this one. In this matchup, he can't because she's just too fluid. The fireballs just means he has to jump. He has
no,
to jump.
No, I meant poison. As a
oh,
character.
Poison. Yeah.
Like 500 backdashes in a row because why not?
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Whee!
Nice uppercut. He needed to do it now. She was on him too much. Lovely throw.
Oh, nice. Ooh. That was so delayed.
Damage. Best list, mate. Best list.
Oh, my good. Grief.
Damage.
Open. Oh,
lovely.
The delay.
Afi is going in right now. This is looking terrible.
Is this gonna be a slapping? Is this gonna be our first 5-0 of the day?
Maybe.
Oh, nice anti-air. Oh,
that was a bit too close. Nice.
Nice punish.
Nice punish.
Oh,
unblockable.
Is that only on Faye? Because that's just nonsense.
Nah, she's got it on other characters,
okay.
But
Faye.
Yeah, Faye wants.
Faye takes unblockables against bare people, man. Like I remember,
deserves it.
Evil Ryu could unblockable him from like his B&B. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. I like the early crouch tip. Nice. Jordan getting a round back.
No, chip. Yeah. Nothing you could do there.
Yeah, he done. He tried the backflip.
Just to change like the timing a little bit.
Yep.
But still.
The backflip's got a lot of recovery. A lot of recovery. There you go. And that's
why
she
goes for the third one.
Hit.
She didn't really have any options there though, to be honest with you. Backdashes.
Nice. I like the stand.
No punish there. Out of range.
Nice.
Bang, bang, bang.
Everything seems to be working right now.
Why is that a hard knockdown?
Unblockably. Good punish. It's minus 16, for those who don't know.
Is it?
Yes. Worse than Ryu's sweep.
Gosh. It's not even fast.
Perks of having a... It's got long range now.
Yeah.
Out of the air?
Oh, no. My God.
I told you already, man. This is poison. I told
really?
You guys,
really?
Her backdash is as good as
seriously?
Gold. I did tell you guys. So, you think Luffy can spam backdash? This
That's
guy can spam backdash.
Mad.
He's my training partner, so I've told him some good things about that. I've told him some very good things.
I'm going to have to use Ultra Double on this and OS with Ultra 2. That's annoying, man.
What? Look, you see that?
Yeah.
Punished a whiff throw off the back there. So it's four.
Is that a delayed throw, at least? That must have been a delayed throw.
Like a normal throw to me. Nice. Punish the jab. Everything working.
Afi's just everything going working. Hamble.
Everything
is
working.
Is it
going
to be 5-0? It's looking like it.
Nice.
Oh!
Hey.
Tell Afi.
Tell him about it today, mate. Hey, best list, mate.
Afi. That was ridiculous.
Juggle, oh, he missed it. Oh, he missed the ball.
He's having a go, isn't he? Man's just using, nice. Man's just using overhead in footsies, you know.
That was sick.
Nice stuff there from Jordan. Jordan's,
I mean,
not
hard,
going down
hard
without
a fight. He had to do it. Good comeback.
I respect that.
I respect that. Nice.
Yeah, can't jump, man. You
I
know
like
you
it.
Can't jump.
Jab himself. Do it. Do himself. And get it back. This matchup, just wake up normal matchup. Block it, Blade. Deal with that, mate. Best list.
Is he just timing that from when he gets up?
Huh?
Is he just timing that from when he, like, if he delay wake ups, it makes no difference. He's just timing it, right?
Yeah, no. If he delay wake up, he can make a difference.
Oh. So why doesn't he just delay wake up?
Because he would just jab.
Stand light punch. Yeah, shout out to stand light punch.
Land on that, mate. Wow. Lovely. I can see the range there.
Oh!
See the range.
Afi.
That's why I was saying the sweep, the range of it is ridiculous.
Yeah.
But that's why it's Mancelot.
Afi's just playing out of his skin right now.
Mm-hmm. And it's match point Afi. Nice anti-air. Nice punish.
Yeah,
ready.
Guaranteed. Super guaranteed. It's minus 8 at least.
Nice guaranteed. Cool. Oh, he missed
oh,
it.
Doesn't oh, get right.
the missed the punish.
It's alright. Still got the life lead.
Look at that Afi game.
Forward dash, back dash.
What can you do, mate? Good trade on the... If you're not used to that timing, it's not going to work, mate.
This looks torrid, man. Not like torrid, but like really frustrating.
Nice.
Mad frustrating. And Afi's definitely going to close this out. Like, I can't see a way in that he's not going to close this out. Unless he does something really stupid. Like, take that throw.
Nice, Jordan,
yeah,
take
the throw. Oh! Nah,
mate. Oi, Afi. Best list, mate. Best list.
Afi gets today's
best
first
list,
fight.
Mate.
Oh! I've got call outs.
Oh, Afi, best list, innit?
Dre wants to defend the list. He's going to calling out Pax.
Best list, mate.
Afi, come and sit down with me again, man. We're going to get Dre and Pax. No, Pax. I said Pax. Dre's changing his mind. He wants comps instead. He's backing up.
Hello.
Dudley versus Poison's alright. I don't mind it that much, to be honest.
That's yours. That's mine. So Dudley Poison what?
I know Sketchy Sempre is saying that Dudley versus Poison is plain bad. I don't mind it.
It's plain bad.
Abel isn't super free. You just watch Smug play online Abels that can't deal with standing light punch. Dudley against Poison.
I think it's pretty in Poison's favour.
How much in Poison's favour?
I think it's...
If I can actually block your nonsense cross-up flips.
You can't OS me. That's
what do you mean
big
I can't OS you?
You can't OS my off a meaty, like low, not one of your...
Why
jump.
Can't I OS you?
My backdash is too good, no?
No, I was going to say I'm going to switch to double ultra and I can OS you with ultra 2.
Ah, okay. Right.
And it catches the idea, same as Chun and Rose.
Okay, cool.
Ultra 2 just swallows you. but yeah, I can't. I don't think I.
It's just difficult
actually
getting
think,
in.
I think I can OS you with sweep because your backdash range isn't that good.
No, sweep is way too slow.
Sweep isn't slow.
Dudley's sweep is too slow for Poison's backdash.
If I meet you with light punch, right? Mm. And the sweep startup's only 6 frames.
I think a backdash is like.
Unless your backdash is like 12 frames, which it isn't. Pretty sure I can. The only reason it wouldn't work is if. It whiffs, or yeah, if you backdash too far.
I think her backdash is pretty far.
Sketchy Sempre, tell me, please, right now, if I can OS Poison's backdash with crouching medium kick.
Oh, I thought you meant crouch fierce.
Crash Fierce? What are you talking about, you lunatic?
That's a sweep.
Oh, Crash Roundhouse. Yeah, no one OS is that.
Oh, but if you meteor it really meaty, doesn't that mean that I'm airborne and I would whiff? I'm invincible to your...
No, but then you land in the active frame.
Oh, is it quite active, that Crash Meteor?
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't worry about that. Afi was talking nonsense.
Hey. Shaki Senpai, we should play when I get to Milan.
Yeah, that would be
finally
cool.
Get to play a serious, a good Dudley.
Yeah.
I'm joking. No.
Why can you not? Is it because the range? Oh.
This matchup is awful as well. Cody gets... This is Cody's worst matchup. I went Andreas' maniac mode. This is what I call controlled lunacy. It's like... He's mad die kicking at annoying ranges where he wants you to anti-air, but you... No, don't. Just don't anti-air. Andreas is the most read-based player I know. He's so read-based, even though Rufus is cheap. Not really. But like, that's why I'm sad to see him not go to tournaments anymore. I think...
I don't think that's going to stick, man. I refuse to believe that. Ultra 1. So why would Ultra 2 not work?
Ultra 1 is better damage.
No, I'm sorry, I'm asking. I'm talking about the chain.
I swear that's not a true string.
Oh, wait, shush, man. I've got 2.5k PP.
Rufus is not... Rufus cheap?
Nah, not anymore.
Not anymore. He can't, you know, Dre is...
I mean, that Inco stuff's cheap, but like...
Yeah. I don't think that's like... I don't think that's game-changing tech. That focus into throw thing. So Cody does not have many, many anti-airs for the dive kick.
No.
And he doesn't have a good back dash. So he has to kind of take it and doesn't have a really good reversal. So dive kick character is pretty much... Actually, I don't think... Why? It's funny. Like, Yan is a dive kick character. Yang is a dive kick character. But Rufus is a different type of dive kick character that bodies.
Because he's got no height restriction on his dive kick.
That's the difference. Well. Blows up crash text. Ah, nice.
No.
See the jab? Baited. when are we going through that?
Probably in about 5 minutes.
Cool. Yes. I want to watch it again.
Yeah. All good.
You know those 6 matches that you actually like after the tournament, you watch it a couple times.
Gourmet.
On the train watching SF games. Gourmet games. I'm not gonna lie. I've been on the train and been watching Daigo vs Momochi Stumpfest Grand Finals. Looking at the gourmet.
The Michelin star matches. Andreas, you know.
Goodbye.
No, you may not have that life lead.
Where is this set up? Oh, nice. And then...
Nice bait. Really nice bait.
Nice bait.
That's good character knowledge. Knew that would whiff. And also knew that...
I think it's the safest thing to... One of the safest things to do, because you can dive kick the anti-air.
Yeah.
From that range.
And
so
it work against this EX Zonk as well. Nice stuff there from Dre. Gets the corner. Walk forward hard.
Cody really needs to get in and that's a bad... That's one of those...
Yeah.
You don't want that in tournament. No. You get stand. Stand throw is so annoying when you get it. Nice, Antia. Oh, he
dabbed. I pressed the button.
He pressed the button. Shout outs to Femi. Flemmy.
Is he at home watching, man?
I'm assuming he watches every week. I'm sure he watches.
He's at home watching, playing online on his alt, you know, his alt account as well.
His alt account. Wait, is this alt account? What's that Turkish player's name? Do you remember? The Ibuki, used to play Ibuki as well. Bear Laggy. Oh, what was that guy's name?
Erdem.
Erdem Tech, yeah, that's the F word Erdem Tech. Alias, bro. What are you hiding? In your Tesco bullgun. You know, I really.
You really what?
Threw me right off.
I could really go for a Totino's pizza roll right now. I'm really hungry. Oh, nice. That was really nice there from Prax.
I think he obviously met EX. Come on,
Schiacci sempre.
Just because he's hurt doesn't mean he lags, right? Alright. Take that. Got him in the corner. Oh. Also, Dre, there's no need to do that. Oh, that was risky.
That was lovely.
He just waited. Oh, don't stand, bro.
Correctly identifying that was too far away to Ultra.
I think Pax just kind of gave it away. He wanted an anti-air there. He wanted an anti-air Ruffian. It's too far away. Nice. Minus there from the cross-up. Oh, yeah, that's it. I can't wait for the Halloween costume to come out.
Oh, for who?
Poison one looks sick. Some of them look whack, I'm not going to lie.
Sagat's one is so dead. He's a clown. Why is he Bozo the Clown?
He's it the clown.
Are you just trying to tell people that, like... He's just whack. He's meant to be the king.
Not no king anymore.
Nah, man.
Nice. Now, this is a situation. You have three bars, you're Rufus.
Stun, you know.
Stun. Wow. Off of an ultra. One more hit and then stun. Horrible.
That rush down.
That just reminds me of Super Seth when he used to get tap.
Last hit,
SPD, stun. And
the
then
SPD. Do you know what? Either the last hit of the taps would kill, always, without fail, or you get stunned off the SPD afterwards.
That's the worst.
The two things that always happen, guaranteed.
And you'll die guaranteed after that. Any character, Hugo, you'll die. You get full damage. Probably got four bars by that time as well.
You die.
Is combo thing going to be at
Milan? Yeah, he is actually. Milan. Yeah.
Actually, there's a couple tournaments we haven't really talked about. We missed the Brazil tournament as well, right?
We went through Kioma. Not today, but last week.
Last week, okay, cool.
Ancient history, mate.
Yeah, sorry. But he's apparently come to DreamHack.
And we also went through Bonchan against Kazunoko in Grand Finals last week as well. I know you were watching, obviously. I know you watch every week.
Anyway, I'm out here. TGS. That's it.
Yeah.
No, Hyakushu.
Hyakashi!
Hyakashi! So, my favorite character in the game, DJ, made it to top four.
Yeah.
Man, he's proving me wrong.
Proving that your choice to drop him is because you are a fraudulent player.
Well, he did say in his interview, people don't know the character, that's why he puts him mid-tier, which is kind of weird. Why would you put a character mid-tier because no one knows how to play against them? That's not the reason of a tier list, right?
I don't know.
A tier list is what you actually think is the strongest
character. It's like half a tier list, and but also like half part of the meta game as well,
because if you can get away with...
It was like... You know when they used to do tier lists based on like matchup, adding up everyone's matchups?
Yeah, right.
Like Honda always used to be really high up, right? In those tier lists.
Yeah,
it's like, Honda, like he must be top 10. But then you look at it, it's like he loses to all the top tier characters.
Yeah, right.
So like, he's like, it's a waste of time picking him because when you get to like the end of the tournament, he's never going to win.
Wow, was that even like a hit confirm? Why was that the slowest super in the world? Like, Pax gets his first game on the board.
Good stuff there from Pax.
Andreas getting nervous.
You're seeing why
his fingernails.
You can see why this is tough, though, for
Cody.
Yeah,
for sure. You really do have to... it's just like against Guile. Cody has to take the knockdown as his last knockdown he'll ever get.
I was talking to RMZ before about dive kick characters, and like, if you haven't really got a lot of options to deal with their dive kicks in the air, then it's always good to like walk forward and block. Because obviously you reduce their frame advantage, yeah? But against Rufus, that obviously is irrelevant because he can dive kick from any height. So he hasn't. He just, like you said, he just has to take the pressure. can't really reliably anti-air the jump in and the dive kick as well, so it like puts questions in his head.
Yeah, that's why he makes like characters like Yun and Rufus strong characters in the game, because there's quite a few characters that don't really have the best options against dive kicks, I think.
Yeah.
Dudley one of them, right?
Dudley's really good against dive kicks.
You think so?
If I'm honest, yeah. He's got loads of normal buttons that have got great horizontal range. Mm. And like, if you dive kick into a standing fierce and you're Yun, like, don't want to do that.
No, you don't want to do that.
You don't want to do that. You take six of them and you're dead. So, yeah. Oh, nice.
Oh, he doesn't want to block. That looks like it might be an unblockable, like, hard to blockable, as they say.
Hard to blockable.
Oh. Don't waste your bar.
He's got a crouch fierce for his trouble.
Oh my god, how did that hit?
Dre.
Wow.
I don't know how Dre makes things hit.
Near the corner enough. What's this going to be? Nice conversion. Wants to get out. Yes, it is a premier event. Milan is a premier event.
Yeah, it is a premier event. It means there's a guaranteed qualifier. It means there's a lot of points on... up for grabs.
A lot of points.
On the line is what I meant to say. But there's a lot of players there fighting it out. We did go through the player list. Let me go for it again for any of you guys who have tuned in late.
I think the characters that are coming from Asia, the characters that people use,
yeah,
I think they're well known here.
Reasonably, I mean, so we've like got Haitani, who's...
Rufus and Makoto.
Well, Makoto we don't know, don't really. Really know, no. V-Ryu hasn't been playing for a long time. Gonzalez, we know. Seth, obviously. Cape Rad using Kami. We can deal with Kami quite well. MOV is using Ibuki now.
We all know that.
We definitely know the Ibuki matchup, but MOV is a very good...
He's very solid.
Ibuki. Raketsu coming over with...
Vega. I don't think we even know Vega to the full extent. Of
Not really. Fudo with...
Fudo's coming?
Yeah, Fudo's coming.
Hey, I want to play him.
We definitely know Fei Long in Europe. We were the first country to know... We were the first continent to really know
Fei Long,
I think. Zian with Gen, which we don't really know that well, I don't think.
He has a plethora of characters.
Who's RB using at the moment?
I think he's using Hugo and Guy.
Okay.
Wait, is he Guy? I don't remember. All I remember is his Hugo.
Kindebu could be using anyone
Eleanor.
On the day.
I think he's going to use Eleanor.
Eleanor we don't really know. Yeah. No one really knows Eleanor. We've got a few Sagats though, so that should be alright.
Yeah. Just make sure you block...
Shiro, I think, is coming, and Tompi.
Okay, I think
a good mix.
I think Europe can defend itself. You know, Europe has a lot of strong players.
Yeah. It's just going to be a bloodbath.
Yeah. K-Brad is going to be at Milan. He needs them points.
And he gets caught with a red focus. Andreas throws his hands in the air.
He's like, wah,
I've got to work hard to win this. Meh, just carry on playing.
Nice
ruffian. I got the trade. I got the trade into Tings. Who shall I play today?
Who should you play? I think. You should play Jordan because he's on a good streak right now.
I don't want to play Jordan.
He's on a good streak right now.
I don't want to give Jordan 5-0.
Top five, mate.
Jordan will pick Geef and 5-0 me. I'm telling you.
He doesn't play that Fei Long matchup. He doesn't play Fei Long.
No, he just knows that he'd probably 5-0 me with Fei Long as well, to be honest.
I think you should play.
Shall I play a retirement match with Dre?
Beat in one round, one game. Yeah, that's it. If only Tyrant was here, I would want you to play Tyrant. Oh, what was that?
You know that match is still not on YouTube?
Really?
No. They're hating on the kid.
They're hating on him.
I know, man. Match point here for Andreas. All of the bar.
Nice throw.
All of the bar.
Wow, he just presses a button and wake up. Catches him.
Nice. Blows up the Fugazi setup with a ruffian kick.
So he has an unblockable setup with it. Wow, nice whiff punish.
Those whiff punishes are so good.
See
man.
How quick his focus crumples into level 2.
Yeah.
Wow. A box out of nowhere. Got him in the corner. Now he has his chance. Now he needs to get a game back from Pat. Oh, nice. Yu's gonna focus.
Styling on guys.
I think this is not dead, but he's got a chip.
And take the... Yeah.
The ultra for there. Maybe not.
Pax frustrated.
So that wasn't even guaranteed. No, that wasn't too soon. Yeah, but he had EX move.
Pax.
Huh? Issan wants to body me.
Issan wants to body you. Have we got time for that? And how long is this video? Is it 15? Mm. Oh, you're playing it like that? Okay.
That's fine. No, no.
All right, we're going to take a 30-second break, and Afi and Issam are going to play. And then after that, we're going to go through the infectious Gagapa.
Infectious. Let's go.
Pax is going to join me again. 2 seconds, and we'll be right back.
Yeah.
Hello, hello, hello.
So how free is Afri?
Afri? I don't
Afri.
Know. Hello.
Hello.
Thank you very much for coming in today. I really appreciate it. It's always a pleasure having you on the show.
Yeah, thank you.
It's a pleasure watching you play any time, to be honest with you. There's no punchline. It's genuinely
no,
a pleasure watching
you
play.
I'm enjoying myself today, actually. You know, some days you're just playing and you're feeling it.
What on earth am I watching?
Islam's got a guy, apparently. In fact, I've seen it in some videos of this guy online. I think he's alright.
I don't know what to say. So how was your experience at Kakatop?
Oh, just great. It was really good. I enjoyed every second of it. Really did.
So what was that tweet about, though?
Oh, that was... It's like kind of personal issues, I'll be honest.
Okay.
It's more like...
Because the timing made it look like you were disappointed with your
performance. I mean, I was disappointed, but I was kind of... It was what it was. It didn't make me upset at all.
Yeah.
I felt like I played my best. I gave it my all and I wasn't good enough.
So, like, does that just refer to, like, big events? Like, travelling and that sort of
stuff?
Yeah.
I will still play. Yeah. Like, you know, London
and, like,
events
and stuff.
But I'm just not going to travel.
Okay. Well, it's pretty short notice as well. Like, you hadn't booked up Milan and you haven't booked up DreamHack anyway, so...
I mean, it's also, it's just very stressful. Like, I think traveling a lot, for me anyway, I think it's just really stressful.
And it can be really expensive in Europe as well, like, because the distances aren't very far, but like, I know Milan is costing people like hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of pounds.
Really?
Yeah, like, I know the flights are really expensive. Like, you look at DreamHack as well, the accommodation's really expensive.
Yeah.
So, it's a big strain, and obviously, you guys are quite young still. I mean, I know you guys are in like your 20s now, you've been playing the game for a while, but still a bit of a strain. But I'm glad that you're still enjoying the game.
I wasn't before Kakuto, I'll be honest with you. And then I think after, like, I was playing so much when I was in France, so I was like playing loads and loads of games, and like, I went to Leo's place and I was playing loads of games with him. I kind of got back into it, and I was having a lot of fun. So the game's not
I really
that
just
bad.
Think that's all it is. Like, I just think it's just like, you're not getting the opportunity to play as much as you might like against the sort of competition that brings the best out of you.
Yeah,
because
definitely.
Like, you're not a player that I don't think like you're motivated by just winning. Like, I think you just like playing
GGs.
Well and
yeah
like and putting this and like using your brain, because you're you know, in game, like, your adaptation incredible, like,
thanks,
noticing people's patterns and coming up and exposing that, and your play over long sets as well, especially like playing long sets, you definitely notice it.
Yeah, I feel like I'm confident in long sets, but just sometimes I feel like maybe I'm wrong about this, but with Rufus I feel like you have to play too perfect at something at a high level.
Yeah.
You can't really just make a bad read at high level. You could die from it. So it's like,
and
it's kind of
so
disheartening.
Well,
I just don't think it's there for him to win a major anymore.
I think with Rufus as well, like, I know you still come up with new stuff, but like, fundamentally the character seems very stale. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, kind of got to milk him for what, like.
Yeah,
got,
like, okay,
there is
like
some stuff. There is some
bits
stuff.
And pieces,
good,
and obviously like that weird Incotech.
The Incotech, yeah, that's so
there.
Cheap, man.
But like, predominantly like his. Like,
do you know what?
Offense?
I think if there was more Rufus players, then this throw tech thing would have been patched by now, because it's actually really cheap.
Yeah.
I think there's no Rufus players doing it.
It's definitely a glitch and it's broken.
It's
in the game,
broken
like,
as hell, but. Nobody's really complained about it, because nobody does it with Rufus, and there's not many
Rufus
players.
And we can just leave it. We'll just leave it, and because it's not like a huge issue. Uh-oh. Shout out to Take the Round, boys. Bad slide. What do you think about Guy in this game? He's like a confusing character to me.
I don't know. I think he's got a really solid rush down, but I've never really understood him that as well as I'd like to.
We've never really like been exposed to him that much in Europe, have we? Apart from, obviously, your nemesis.
No, I think it would be interesting if like Big Bird or something came to London, like a bracket.
He's
reset.
Coming.
He'd
to, he's trying
win.
To come to SGB, right?
I think so. He's trying to get
a
visa.
Yeah, he's trying
something.
To get a visa to come over. So that'd be great. Because Guy's a really interesting character. I think he's like, he has got limits, obviously holes, but like that pressure, so good. I mean, remember the first time that we really ended up having to play against like Mark Teddy, for example.
Oh yeah, I remember the first time I played Mark Teddy. Oh, it was awful.
Yeah,
it felt really hard because like, his strings were so tight.
He ran through that European team, man.
Yeah. I wasn't on the team, but I played him in like a money match or something just to see. And I like before playing him, I had like.
Because you don't know where the holes are.
I didn't know when there were holes in the strings where I could press buttons. And I think my knowledge of the game wasn't that good back then, so I was kind of bad at exploiting these like pressure strings. But I remember it being really annoying. Anyway, when's Issam going to switch to Dudley?
Huh?
When's Issam going to switch to Dudley?
When's Dudley? Back to the Dudley, as the hoodie said.
Yeah.
What do you think about like Issam trying out these other characters? Do you think he should just really just focus on Dudley? Or?
I don't know. It kind of depends on what kind of player you are.
Do you think
I don't think it suits everyone to use those different characters. Like an infiltration, for example, that's obviously. I think it's kind of like a natural talent to be able to pick up different characters and remember how to use them. Because like for me personally, if I learn a character, like I'll spend 2 weeks on it and I'll get pretty good at them. But if I stop playing them for a while, I'll just go back to being rubbish at them.
Yeah.
So you have to kind of like play the same character over again. That's why I main one character. But people, like I don't know how infiltration does it though.
You
can use anyone at high
I
level.
Was literally standing behind him play Ryan at Evo when he drew for like Evil Ryu, and I'd never seen infiltration use Evil Ryu in my life.
It was so high level.
And he hit every one frame link. His spacing was immaculate.
I know, right?
Like it's incredible, man. Like how did you do that?
When he drew for Abel, top 8 of Evo, top 8, and you beat for Abel. And he won.
And he won as well.
That's
like
crazy.
Best player in the world.
Yeah.
Mad. He's such a talented guy, man. And to think that he does that basically isolated from like a real FGC.
Yeah, I know. I think people don't give that part enough credit. Because he doesn't have a scene, does he? Or he...
I mean, not
a big
Not really. You don't think you don't. It's not like you tune in and watch like Korean monthlies and weeklies.
It's
and
just
stuff
like Hyde Buffy and Pumko and that's about Infiltration.
It. And like laugh now.
Hyde Buffy's crazy. Have you seen him play?
No.
He's nutcase.
Who does he use?
He's Aidon. He's so ragged.
Oh wow. Like, do you still watch streams nowadays? Like,
if like UK plays it, I'll definitely gonna be watching it like this weekend. Is it this weekend with Problem X and Tyrant? I'll definitely be.
So I think they're gonna be at Next Level Battle Circuit tomorrow, actually.
Is that tomorrow?
Yes, Wednesday night.
I hope they don't get. I hope Problem's not jet lagged again.
Well, they've got. They went out today. Problem and Tyrant flew out today. They're in New York now. I know they go Next Level Battle Circuit tomorrow, and they're gonna obviously be at Defend North. So you'll be at home. You'll be watching Milan on the weekend in the daytime, right?
Wait, is Milan this weekend?
This weekend, mate.
There's two. So Problem's not going to Milan.
No.
I wasn't.
We've been discussing that in detail. Have you seen?
Yeah,
I haven't been.
I haven't had like the whole time I was in Paris. I didn't have WhatsApp because I didn't have any data.
Yeah. So basically, Problem's decided like he's basically farming points now, right? Because winning a premier is kind of mythical these days. And he believes that going to Defend the North, you're more likely to get more points than you are than going to a premier, because you get the same points for finishing one place higher at a ranking than you do one place lower at a premier.
Premiers, if you don't win the premier, it's not really there. It's not really there.
No,
in
it
terms
is because if you finish second, you get the same number of points as if you finish first at ranking anyway. Right?
Oh, really?
Yeah, but say like his chances of finishing top three at Defend the North are much better than finishing top four at a premier event. Because have I read
so
the
many
list?
Good no, yeah, like, I don't know. I don't really know.
Okay, so you've got Fudo Xian.
Xian's taking it.
Fudo Xian, Kindevu, Raiketsu, MOV, K-Brad, Gonzalez, Haitani, Shiro, Tompi. RB's there. Like, loads of good players are there. That's a stacked lineup.
That is
players.
A stacked lineup. I think Xian we might take that, to be honest.
So, like, I think for him, he just feels like it's much more profitable, I guess, in terms of points farming to go to Defend the North.
Yeah, I think he's got a good chance of taking Defend the North.
And he said he wants to gatekeep, apparently. Yeah, but we don't really care about top East Coast players, do we? That much.
Top East Coast, who are the top East Coast players?
I don't know.
Other
Smug.
Than Smug, I don't know. Zeus is good. Dominion, but he doesn't really count anymore because he doesn't mean he lives there.
He's in Atlanta now. Yomi.
Is that East? That's not East, is it?
No, it's South. Obviously got Snake Eyes will be there, I'm sure.
So all the East Coast players, basically, and then Smug.
Snake Eyes and couple others. I think all the EG guys will be there as well because they're all like at the bottom. Like,
yeah.
Just below the qualifying spots. So like Rog and Ricky. K Brad's at Milan. Gustavo will probably be there.
I wish I could go. All these names are on the baby's TV.
Yeah, man. We'll get you back soon, man. We'll get you back soon. Like, if Milan didn't cost, like, £600 to go to...
Is that much it costs?
About that, yeah. The flights are three bills at least.
Yeah. And what about the French one? What date is that, the November one?
Is that Street Grand Battle? Is that what you mean? That's
That's
not a Capcom event.
It's not, is it? No. But why there's so many players from all over the world going to it, right?
Because there's good money there, I think.
Oh, is the money good?
Okay. I think so. There we go. Back to Dudley. Hashtag
okay,
back to
Dudley.
Okay,
now let's commentate.
Do you think Dudley is a character that you can main and win a major with, realistically?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Because he's quite solid.
Yeah?
Solid on the ground. I don't really know all his matchups, but from what I've seen, he's so explosive. Maybe more explosive than he is solid, though. So.
I definitely think he's more explosive than solid. He's got weaknesses on the ground, he's got weaknesses on wake up, but like this game kind of, with delayed wake up, it kind of like helps you with weaknesses on your wake up, so that's good. What do you think the Rufus matchup with Dudley is?
Rufus Dudley, 5-5 I think.
Yeah. I like that match, it's a fun match.
I like it, I like playing it. I think it's 5-5. I've changed my opinion about a few matchups as of late, actually.
Yeah.
After speaking to Infectious, shouts to him. Like, we're having some deep conversations about the game.
He's really good at like making you rethink about how you approach
Yeah, after speaking with him, I got some like new ideas with for some characters that I shot. Like when I lost to Venom 3-0, that was a whole new game plan I went with, and I kind of just made a few mistakes with the anti-airs. But if you saw me versus Venom before that, it was even worse. So
okay,
I feel like
nice. Does he get the confirmation though? Unfortunately. It sounds a bit weird, like, oh yeah, I lost 3-0 to Phenom, but like I was really happy with how like my game plan
went. No, because honestly, I don't have an excuse. So I just made the wrong decision, so it's definitely not gonna work. Happy trying the Reinhardt there.
I think Dudley is a character. You'll end up. Like, Eleanor absolutely bodies Dudley horrifically for a start.
Eleanor bodies so many characters ridiculously bad.
Ooh, the trade.
Ooh! Oh, wow, that was chunks. Red
Frozen. Yeah, that trade Crouch Fierce was racking up the stun.
Well, he's bringing it back. Oh, we didn't know they get to 4, so it's 3-2 now. So
yeah.
He can make it. He can probably bring this back if he plays well.
I really like his use of EX Duck to get in. He's kind of doing it similar to how you would against a Guile. Just literally using it to... Oh, nice! Chases down.
How you do it against a Guile? What do you mean?
Against Guile, you just like EX Duck to get in through the... So as soon as
there's a mix-up.
Yeah,
after, right?
But then
if the Guile, like, what if the Guile meshes of Sanfrew? Would it throw him out of the normal?
I mean, it depends, obviously, on your reaction timing. There's 19 frames on EX Duck.
Recovery?
In total, from start to done.
Because what I do, I just buff a jab into Tornado.
Yeah,
seems to work
when you
every
see
time,
it.
But
yeah, it depends. It depends, like, if you're not doing anything, then sure. Like, you can react. It's 19 frames. You can react to 19 frames. Just, yeah, press a button when you see the flash.
Why do the Dudley players never do EX Duck into overhead?
Because that's slow.
It's too slow, isn't it?
And most people will throw. Like,
and they'll press a button and they'll hit the overhead, maybe, I don't know.
Yeah. Most people just stand throw. A lot of people... You know,
it's the best thing to do. Stand frame on reaction is like the safest thing.
Which is why, like, you start seeing people do EX duck and then backswing blow and all that nonsense. But you don't really get anything off that.
Oh no, EX duck into low as well. You do that.
Oh yeah, that's
Islam
like.
Islam and Smug do that quite a lot.
Yeah, that's like a standard. That's a staple. Because his low is like 4 frames, so
yeah,
it's quite sharpish.
His jab's 3 though, right?
Yeah. Oh,
oh
wow, really? That was sick.
That was really good. Didn't even know you could do that.
Yeah, that was sick. That was sick. Nice stuff there from Islam, bringing it back. Islam's a really good player, man. I really respect his play.
Tier 2. Yeah, I think he's really good.
Like, have you noticed much difference in his play? Over
I don't think he's playing at his strongest today.
No.
To be honest with you, but when he gets going, oh, he's really strong.
I feel like maybe consistency might be his biggest downfall.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
like
too many times you don't
see him playing his best.
Yeah.
But when he plays his best, man, it's mad. Like,
he can beat Ryan and Problem.
Yeah.
But he could lose to like someone that's not as good as him, sort of thing.
Someone that he should be beating, definitely. You know, he'll have weeks where he's in grand finals, resetting the grand finals and stuff, and then he'll have weeks where he doesn't even make top 8.
Yeah, definitely.
But he's got loads of talent. What makes him so difficult to play against? For you, if you played him today.
Well, like I said, I don't think he played his best today. He's usually a bit harder than that. But his pressure, his knockdown, which is what I don't think he was excelling at today. Mm. But when he knocks you down, it's generally really scary because of his decision making.
In what sense?
Just like when to bait, when to overhead, sort of.
Oh, so
when
like
you're
his read on what you're going to be doing.
Yeah.
Oh, nice link. That's a one frame link. And he gets the throw and closes a round. Good stuff. Really good stuff there from Islam. I think that's so important for a Dudley player, like having a good read on what the opponent's going to do in any given situation. That is a cross-up. You have to block it standing.
What's the difference between his hard and light DP in terms of invincibility?
They have none of them have invincibility.
Not even like one frame of it.
No invincibility at all. Mm. The only difference is the hard one is three frames, and it hits twice. And the light one is, I think, six frames.
But in terms of just using it on
wake days, up, look
wow,
at that.
Oh, that was really good. Is that for the back dash?
Yeah. Basically, when
that's
you
so fast.
Yeah, it's 8 frames. So basically, when you see them focus, you can just wait for the back dash.
Yeah, no, because I do that with Rufus though, with Ultra 2, but you have to sort of do it straight away. But that's yeah. So you can do it consistently.
It's easier with Dudley because his Ultra's 8 frames, and it's 8 frames. It's not 8 frames plus travel time. It's
yeah, that's
8 frames.
Oh wow, that's crazy.
Yeah.
All right, Islam's bringing this back, man.
Yeah, man, he's turned this right around. Three win streak, and he's looking at match point right now. Really good stuff. Yeah, focusing is not a free Ultra 1 because you can actually absorb the first hit of Rolling Thunder and crumple
it. I see. So you can hold it.
So you have to wait for the back dash. So it's actually harder to do. Like, you have to really wait for the dash to come out. Nice confirm there from...
So the first hit, you absorb the first hit.
Yeah, because it's not an arm-breaking Ultra.
Yeah, yeah.
And the second hit is faster now than it used to be, but you can still crumple.
That's so cheap. Again, I think that's crossing up. Raggle. I think Happy did wake up stand throw. It's quite a tough situation for Dudley, I think.
Yeah. He's got that ultra and it's fast as hell.
He hasn't got any meal. What can he really do? Dashing in.
Oh.
That was a really good dash forward then.
It's a problem when you're looking for that fireball, you get hypnotized almost, and Afi took advantage of that. This matchup's difficult for Dudley because it's hard for him to build bar, hard for him to build meter to get in, which he basically needs. Oh, nice. Oh, unfortunate. Doesn't get the EX machine gun. Bates, that's going to hurt. Doesn't need to spend bar to get the corner.
Wake up level 1.
Afi just does all sorts, man.
He does.
He really does.
Wake up is weird. That, he does backdash a lot in the corner.
Yeah. Her backdash is sick, though.
Yeah.
And again,
yeah,
I mean,
it goes for the cross-up again, but this whist kills it. Kills him for that.
Don't think that's going to kill. Scales quite heavily.
Kill, no. One more mix-up.
He's got to take it, though. What's it going to be? Backswing blow. You ready? Oh, he went for max range overhead. Ah, nice. And now, after being 3-1 down, Issam is on match point. What a comeback. Speaking of comebacks, after this we have
We'll be watching one of the best comebacks of all time.
Exactly. An unbelievable comeback.
Who's going to talk through it?
Who do you think would be the best person suited?
Pax.
Yeah, I was thinking Pax.
I'd do it, but I just don't have the patience to sit through 33 minutes of that like dry bison play.
Oh, nice! Oh, he wasn't able to get duck straight. EX duck straight would have worked and been easy, but the normal one does work as well in the right situation, and you get so much more damage and stun off of that. And again, that whiffs.
No more meter. Afi spent it all on that cross up.
Yeah, Afi had that cross up. That flip whiff several times, and he's been punished every time for it. Oh, and he goes for that overhead. That overhead's so good at that range.
4-4.
So here we go, the signing match. We've had some really good sets today. I've been really happy with the sets that we have had. A lot of them have gone down to the last match. Really close. Really,
I've enjoyed all my sets very much.
Yeah, no, I've definitely enjoyed watching you play again today.
All that Kakatop training.
Yeah, man. Did you do much training for the actual event itself?
Do you know all my training, all it involved was like watching a few videos of Kyungstar.
Yeah.
Because I know he plays Perplex a lot. Mm. And learn, you know, the Incotech?
Yeah.
I just in like, before I got my Eurostar, I was like in my room like for like 4 hours just practicing it over and over again. Because I thought I might, like, I didn't even use it, but just a few other ideas. But anyway.
We use it today. Oh, Afi wakes up with jab, of course. Yeah. So here we go. Set point. Man just walked forward and level two focused. Which is insane against Poison, but he did it anyway. That overhead, not me.
Actually gives up too much ground. Huh? Actually gives up too much ground.
Yeah.
Why is he backdashing twice in a row? He doesn't need to. Does that spacing benefit him?
No. Oh! And again, he was ready. He was ready for the release. Either way.
Cheeky mix up. Ooh.
I don't think that was worth that the bar.
No, he's just trying to stop.
Nice. Oh, and the trade takes it. Really nice stuff there from Issam. Back and forth matchup. Really was punished a lot for those whiff flips.
Yeah, Europe's a great country.
It is. Right, so we're going to go into this infectious and Gagapar set. Can I get Pax over here, please? And you guys feel free to just carry on playing.
I'm probably going to go for a cigarette.
See you later, Ass.
See you later, man. GG's.
All right, guys, in the chat. So what we're going to do is we're going to end up the broadcast tonight with this tremendous set from Infectious and Gagapar from Kakatop this weekend. This was to qualify for the final stages. It's first of five set. They had the... I can't remember what the rules called, but you have to win by two clear games.
Yeah. Infectious the GOAT.
Uh-huh.
The greatest ever. TGE. The TGE.
Infectious, TGE. The MVP of
the greatest ever.
The weekend.
The GOAT.
Let's not even say anymore. Let's go straight into it, please.
Mate, if you haven't seen this, mate. The GOAT, mate.
So here we go. The opening up. He's got that great big ridiculous costume on.
Intimidation.
What are we going to be seeing the most of? We're going to be seeing Gagapar down back and scissoring.
Gagapar is just literally playing his game. He doesn't even abuse the fact that you can jump on a Hugo
when he
has no bar. He literally just plays the ground
can
game.
Can he not anti-air with elbow?
No, not really. Well, he's quite a floaty jump, but you have to be ready.
Yeah.
But he's literally just playing the ground game. But the thing I was looking at when I was watching it with Infectious is, like, as a grappler,
yeah,
trying to play by not jumping is just going to make your life hell.
Yeah.
You, like, have to jump. Like, we know in Street Fighter, jumping's not a good thing because you, like, lose control of your character and you're just susceptible to anything on the ground. But, like, you have to jump as a grappler. You have to take, like, that risk, especially because you have more life.
And you're seeing him with punish those claps.
Yep. And he goes into... He's getting pushed back to the corner, but he just does scissors. On reaction to clap, he might do scissors just to... Push him back.
That time he tries to punish the clap with heavy scissors past the FADC.
And
got the counter hit, but it was a bit too far away.
Oh, it's never too far. He just didn't link it.
No, always links it.
Yeah, always links.
That looked mad far and the pushback was kind of crazy as well.
Especially on counter hit, you can get another heavy cut. Heavy. He decided to jump right at the end when he has no health.
Yeah.
At 6 seconds.
And no time left as well.
JPEG Infectious. Shout out to Damascus. And second round is pretty much the same thing. That's good as well. Meaty throw. It sends him just so far.
Yeah.
So it's just a surprise thing. You're not really going to be ready for a random throw. But, yeah, he knows what to do. He knows what he's supposed to be doing. Because apparently the last time they played, Infectious batted him. So he knows now that when you see the clap, you can press a button just to see if you can punish it.
Is he at risk of getting counter hit though?
If you have a normal that's hits high and far,
like
at 45 or 60 or 80 degree angle,
that light kick's not going to hit you.
You're a lot more, you're a lot less
focus.
You're a lot less likely to get clapped as well.
So this is just a slow, painful death from what we're looking at right now.
Yeah.
Perfect
Yeah, basically everything's working.
Nothing on the ground. I mean, the thing is, he's died there with a full super meter.
Yep.
We've not seen any use of EX Lariat yet. We haven't really seen, like you said, any jumps.
Yeah, EX Lariat especially, like, because that's just for the scissors. It just eats up moves. Yeah, just to show him. I was also saying that literally throughout the whole set, you never see this guy, I don't think he really did, a normal into clap. Just to kind of get pressure going. Just a normal crouching light or whatever. I was saying, try crouching light kick to the stand heavy kick. This was all me just saying to myself. That was a better attempt there. He tried to do something different, but Gagapo was just ready. But
not from that range. Yeah, like, you got too long to react to it there.
Yeah. I was saying he's got crouch medium for the scissors or the heavy kick. It might trade or something. I was just thinking to try and focus on the ground, lower normals to beat the higher normal.
Has he got any sort of far-reaching low normals?
He's a huge guy, so his crouch liking reaches very far.
Yeah.
Ridiculously far. But the patience is nuts. I just can't believe how patient he was for that long. And that was just basically general grappler stuff.
So that's two perfects back to back.
Yep. Two back to back perfects.
Mad. And he's still not changing up. Like, he's still playing his patient game. He is stubborn. As much as the guys were making jokes about his facial expression not changing, his play style won't change either. He'll stick to his plan.
If it's something tried in training mode and he knows it's supposed to
definitely
work,
works.
He will be like, no, this is supposed to work. Yeah. But that is so good. The way he's patient with his character. This much patience with a character that does so much damage and has so much health, it's just scary because he's just not going to lose too much composure. Like, he's not going to lose composure too much.
That was a really nice whiff punish. That time he got it perfectly.
So he's kind of learning himself.
Yeah.
The timing to whiff punish. But as I said, Bison's got a stand heavy kick, which is like an angled normal that hits high enough.
Yeah.
Jump there. So bringing in jumps a bit.
And he can just throw that out. It looks like he can just throw that out for free.
If it hits high and up, because he's got a fast one as well, the claps are kind of like angled down.
Anti-airs with it as well. It's like
the Herbox is angled down. Herbox is angled down on the clap, so you need a high and far hitting normal, which is why Chun-Li does so well against him. Because hers just hits ridiculously far.
Throwing out.
And that was ridiculously unsafe. I don't know why he did that. And he got himself into trouble, but he gets out because he's Bison.
And that's another thing as well. When he did get in, he was just really doing just sort of safe OS pressure as
Literally,
well.
Literally, yeah. Everything was... there was no reason.
Now, if you're going to focus at that range, why would you not...
Focus back?
Try a Lariat as well. Like, EX Lariat. Why would you not at least try EX Lariat?
And again, it goes back to the safe play. He's trying to play taking zero risk. That is safe as possible. And you can't... As a grappler, you really can't kind of play
that. He's sort of dying by cuts rather than...
Like, imagine if Zangief tried to play zero risk. You'd never SBD. You just...
Look, there's Damascus. Oh, wow, this is like Inception. Commentary Inception.
Yeah.
Right now. Look at that. That's crazy.
Yeah, commentary going on. But yeah, as a grappler, you can't play without a risk.
No, you have
to. You'd never SBD then.
I mean, look at Snake Eyes.
Yeah.
Snake Eyes...
Even though he does it,
manages to pull off some crazy risks.
He might do it at smart times.
Yeah, he's an incredibly solid player. His reads are really good. Like, his footsie game is immaculate. His whiff punishing is immaculate. But he does some insane stuff, and it works because he pulls it out at the right time.
His
and right
two
now,
reads as well.
He's looking at another perfect.
Yep. Even the timings for his SPDs, like the jump-ins, and then he neutral jumps. That shouldn't really be happening. Especially in what Infectious usually does is if you jump in on him and it's like a... If you jump in on him and it's like a deep enough jump in where he can't mash SPD to punish you, he'll do a stand throw. Because if you jump away from the stand throw, you're getting EX backbreak, guaranteed. And that's another safe thing that Infectious does a lot. And there's not much you can do about that. You either frame trap him...
Right, there's people in the chat right now that haven't actually seen this match and they're wondering why this Hugo's even here. That's cool. You keep saying that because...
I swear.
Yeah, obviously.
Okay.
The second half of this film is definitely a little bit different.
Yeah, the plot twist.
Yeah.
A very good plot twist. But
Kevin Spacey is actually Kaiser Soze.
Oh.
He keeps putting corner pressure.
Yeah, he keeps putting himself in the corner, which is crazy. But even in the corner, he's doing well.
Yeah.
And you know Gagapo already, he can maximize damage with his character that shouldn't be doing that much damage, but he can. And as you see, again, you haven't seen any low normals or anything. No contesting the stand heavy kick. No normals.
He's
just
trying
the challenge
to contest it with like focus dash forward.
Yeah, it's not. It wouldn't be quick enough anyway.
Yeah.
But yeah, he's not contesting it at all. He's just like literally just taking it and trying to clap around it.
Or like counter poke as well. Mm. But
and there he got one. He got one hit.
Jumping.
Yeah, from a jumping.
Is that dead? Yes.
Ooh. No. He doesn't take. I don't think he takes it around.
Yeah, of course he did. EX scissors.
And that's one of those things where finally I got in on Bison. So he's trying to do stuff and that's what happens. He just does his Bison stuff.
Because he's been building bar for the whole round, just throwing scissors out for fun.
That's it though. He was close to taking a round.
But it was off of jumping.
Yes, that's the closest he got from because he jumped. Mm-hmm. I just think as a grappler, you have to jump, and you're given the life for these risks. You're given the life for that reason.
Yeah.
And Invictus is usually one to use his health as a.
I think it was
as a kind of
Cantona against Arturo.
Cantona against Dalsim Arturo Sanchez.
And he literally blocks with his face the whole round.
Because when he gets in, it's just
and
peak.
And then gets
like,
in and it's horrible.
Yeah.
Literally gets in once after blocking with his face the whole round.
And it's pretty easy for Bison to anti-air with stand heavy kick, but he really has to be looking for the jump.
Yeah.
Because if you press a button like early or anything, you can't hear him straight out.
Yeah. And Hugo's not the easiest character to deal with as well when he jumps because...
He's a huge character.
Nice.
Yeah, he's a huge character with a very short jump. Mm. And he finally gets the meat squasher, gets the follow-up, that's 320 damage.
Nice. And there he is using the armor. But again, he wakes up with a scissor.
That was a safe clap. But he's been doing that every single time he gets a knockdown anyway.
Because he's committed to this safe play.
Yep, committed.
Minimal risk, which is a great way to play. Definitely recommend
it. As a grappler, you get... very minimal damage also.
Yeah, it's true.
And no time left and he's still contesting.
Yeah,
he's
trying to focus dash forward through again.
It's too slow.
And again, he's died with basically full super meter.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Gagapa's not jumping at him, so he doesn't need for the EX backbreaker. No. Gagapa's got no reason to jump at him, honest with you. so he doesn't need that bar for the anti-air.
Nope.
The chance of him landing super are very low because he's probably not going to get into the range where he's going to land that.
He's not even poking.
No.
Like he's not even... Well, he's doing high pokes, which are good because the high pokes do counter the stand heavy kick, but that's if you time it at the right time.
Yeah, and that's really difficult. To be honest with you, I've watched Infectious play against Valmaster as well, who uses a character, Chun Li, who's got far roundhouse, which is a similar situation. You just throw it out for free.
Yeah.
Counter poking, it's a myth. You know, it's not in your favor. The trade's not in your favor.
Nope. You get pushed back. And he gets a counter hit. Usually he hit
and what are you getting? It's a jab. Like, oh, cool. Yeah. You got a jab. Well done. Great. I'll just go back to pressing the same button again. It's not going to put you off. I would definitely like to see him start using the X Lariat.
Yeah,
he gets a punish, but you've got the health to risk.
That's something. He needs to take those risks.
Because you want to be in. That's where you want to be. Oh,
and
wow.
And again, he's so good at that.
That was
sick. That's just a basic... like frame trap throw mix up, but he's so good at that. Why is Bison doing that?
Yeah.
And again, just slowly look, he's just getting mauled, man. But with full meter, he's not even doing like crouching light into EX claps. Just something like that.
So this is the first of five set.
Yeah.
And Gagapa's 4-0 up right now.
This is his game. Look how he's playing. He's not showing
any signs of cracking.
Nothing.
Infectious is not showing any sort of signs of anywhere near him.
What is he supposed to do? Like, it doesn't look like he's supposed to do anything.
The thing that I'm suggesting is he's mad unsafe. Big risk.
Yeah.
You know, you're suggesting he jumps more. Like,
yep. But there we are.
You're telling him to at least contest. Look,
there's our first normals into claps.
Yeah,
those are happening.
He's anti-air with the elbow as well.
He got a bit frightened of the damage.
Nice,
so he's starting to jump now.
Okay, so he's got a setup now, and again he goes for the safe
Yep, but look, the claps into normals.
Yep.
The normals into claps, sorry. The normals into claps or what? But allows him to get a bit
least,
more pressure.
He's at least on a life.
A life
parity.
Lead, yeah.
Like, he's at least got the same life. He's not like a huge life deficit.
And that was unsafe. He didn't cancel it. I'm not sure why, but that was unsafe. And again, look, safe jumps. Look.
Yeah. He's actually able to get into a range now where he's able to connect with that yep. light kick that he can cancel.
And look, he's spamming it.
He wasn't
the trade
able.
Now.
Yeah,
there you go.
There
and
go.
There you go.
That
light,
sharp
light into a clap. And it's not true. That was not true blocking.
Gagapur was doing really yeah. well, keeping it mid-range where he couldn't yeah. land that. That light was out of range.
Yeah, that wasn't the combo there.
He's dashing in, though, like, preemptively, dashing yeah. in and throwing out that light.
It's the range and just the fact that he's
to be
not
honest,
going
to
react.
If you can make people block clap,
yeah,
that's
what you want. Yeah.
That's you winning the game, yeah. basically. So if he can get into that range, if he can dash into that range yep. and throw out that light kick and get claps blocked.
Yeah. Then this is his first round, by the way.
Yeah.
So he's
lost 8 straight.
Yeah.
And he's in the corner, and Bison's got full super.
Yep.
Not even. That's his first bit of health.
Look at the health, man. The health difference right now is ridiculous.
Nice
and that's
focus
a new
back
thing
dash,
he was trying it in the matches previously, a yeah. focused back dash to scissors, and try yeah. and punish with a SPD.
The grab, yeah.
But his back dash is a little bit too slow, but it's a good option.
At that range, yeah.
Yeah. And there you go, he had clap.
Nice.
Just to
and
make him block.
So
and he got scared.
Block stun on that as well.
Right to the other corner now, and now he's got to deal with it. He missed it. That's fine.
Missed
safe.
It, but it doesn't really matter if you yeah. miss it. It's just a different mix up.
Yeah. Safe. So now he's still doing the same walk forward, wall kind of thing. But you're seeing a bit more claps, a bit more normals into clap. He's jumped a few more times. And now he's doing forward dashes, like preemptive forward dashes.
Mm.
Look, you got a clap there. Nearly got the conversion. Nearly got the conversion there.
He wasn't able to anti-air.
And he tried to ultra that. That is possible on scissors. And time is just up now. He can't yeah. do anything.
He should have just built bar.
Yeah.
He never gives up. Yeah. Like, he actually never
even
gives up.
Even at the 2 second mark. So basically, it's match point. Set
yeah,
point.
This is it now.
For Gagapur.
One more set, and Gagapur closes it out.
And
opens
he starts
up
off
with,
a life lead, which is scary. And Gagapur is known to just
straight
sit
away.
On life lead.
Straight away, he's there.
Still going for that stand jab. It is a good option for scissors and stand heavy kick, but it's just the fact that
it's
trade.
It's keeping him scared, yeah. But
yeah.
the trade's not in his favour. The pushback on block,
yeah.
it's not good either. Like,
meter usage. You use meter for
not
ES
from
clap.
There. I don't
yeah.
think he should have done it from there, but maybe he's just trying to catch something.
Yeah.
That time he does get a counter hit, but look at the damage
yeah.
that did.
He
Nothing.
Didn't. But the thing is, he should have cancelled it. That's what should be happening. And he's taking a lot of damage from stand heavy kicks.
And he's just maintaining that range where he can just safely scissors.
Yep. Gagapur will not move if he doesn't have to.
No. That there time he jabs him out of the scissor startup.
It's a good way to push him back, but it's just like, look, as soon as, like, if you miss and he hits you.
No, you're giving up all of that.
Yeah.
And again, he's not cancelling that. Crouch Fierce he's using. That's minus bear on block.
And he gets the hit.
Look at the life.
Yeah. And that is what happens.
Oh, buffering.
That is what happens when you get hit once.
And he's out. But he's got a life lead.
He's got a life lead now.
He's going to probably, to be honest with you, he can probably chip him. Like down, so that's the. There's not.
There's some chip there, and that's
he's
what he's going for.
Just throwing it out. Nice.
And this is scary now. I don't know how he keeps composure here. What is going on?
Oh, there we
but
go.
But whatever, you see the life
the
lead.
Playback.
And somehow, Infectious.
How does Infectious? Oh no! Allow it. What happened? Come on, man! Can't have this. No, it's all right. Just
don't worry.
Play.
Leave it.
Anyway,
somehow he made that comeback. I don't know what that lag was about, but somehow he made a comeback. That chip,
yeah.
he killed him, didn't he? He done his clap and then he done a crouching light kick.
Yeah.
So he's finally got a game, like finally.
So he's brought it back,
and it was only just. It wasn't like anything special.
No. Oh, come on, man. What's happening? Sorry about this, guys.
Same game. Wow.
Pause it a sec. What's happening? Talk to me.
Can't have this, mate.
All right, let's go again.
Same game again. Oh, he gets the clap and he's getting the hit confirmed now.
Okay, he doesn't get the full, but that's definitely enough damage to put the fear
there
of God.
There we go. And that's it. After that one clap, he's starting to dash now. So he's mixing
it
up.
The strongest thing that Hugo's got is the fear element. Yep. Like, more so than any other grappler. Grapplers operate on fear really well, but Hugo is really terrifying because he doesn't need to grab you.
Yeah, exactly.
To peel off
he
all
needs
your
to
life.
Clap you.
And again, he's able to dash in. That was a good read. So after the scissors, he's at minus. He doesn't want to throw out a button because get counter hit.
He's been back dashing after the scissors as well.
Yeah, so forward dash. He identifies that he's not going anywhere. SPD. Nice stuff. Now he's trying to go with medium kick as a whiff punish.
Medium kick is extremely difficult to whiff punish for any character.
Mm. That
nice
was a really
punish.
Nice whiff punish from Gagapar.
And
really
again, he's
stuff.
Got the life lead. He's doing all the right things. And you can't do that against him, against Hugo.
No one's got bar. He's ready. I think there's a guaranteed punish
nice.
On that.
And he's doing the normals now. This is
killing it.
This is definitely
killing my vibe, Kendrick. But we're back to the footsies. Considerable life lead again from Gagapar, as to be expected.
But literally, it just takes one clap for Hugo.
Yeah.
A life lead could be whatever. And he only needs one bar. And he shouldn't have done that.
Gagapar
kind of cracking for no reason. And that option select. And now it's even, basically.
And mentally, he's like, oh, see, that was a good choice.
Good option, but he's basically shown Gagapar that he will do that.
I will option select you, so.
That wasn't even an option. That was an empty clap. And he got the clap.
Oh,
again.
Was it empty, yeah?
Yeah, that was an empty clap into. And that's it. Second game. Two rounds straight.
Good stuff.
He's landing the claps now. And that might be just from the fear that he might dash up, so he might be doing a different timing now for the dashes.
I'm just thinking to myself, why would that ever be an option select? Of course it wasn't an option select. Option select with Ultra 1. Nah. My apologies. It's a brain fart. It's been a long day. I've been up since 6 a.m.
And he's doing the stand jab. The stand jabs are working now. And the jump. There we go. The first jump we've seen that landed. And he's basically taken off all that health. He started to use standing medium punch. He hadn't been using that at all. And that's not guaranteed. It's 4 frames on star. But if you stay still, you're going to get hit, basically.
We can't download it, by the way. Oh, that's why we're having to play.
Yeah. And the stand jab again. In that situation, it's extremely hard for Bison to do anything.
Oh, I've been told apparently that's the original French stream was lagging. So there you go.
Okay. Yeah, fair enough.
Is this off the UM channel? Yeah, the French feed.
Yeah, no, the French stream was lagging.
Apparently the French, okay, that's what it was. All right, so it's not our fault.
Yeah, he's going for the stand jab. And that stand heavy punch there was just for the scissors, just in case you can actually absorb one hit and hit him before he gets the second hit out.
Back to the hard kick.
And you can see now that Gagapar's kind of like hesitant to just throw out a normal because he's been clapped so many times.
Mm.
So even though...
And again, it's that fear. Now that he's imposed that fear on Gagapar, he's able to do more things. It's allowing him to dash in.
Yeah.
It's allowing him to get into that range where he can throw out the buffered normals into the claps.
Yeah, and the thing is, he's not even taking advantage of it too much right now. He's still playing patient, but Gagapar's just scared now. He just doesn't know what he wants to do now. He's just scared.
He's giving up charge all the time as well.
Yeah, still doing a stand jab just to check him, just in case. There you go, and that's what happens. You get checked. He's mixing up though, so he's done a backdash the second time. And the jumps, there we go, dash in, now the jumps. Gagapar's not even ready now.
Yeah, and he's in the corner for the,
look, there
the,
you go.
The first time.
He doesn't hit confirm, but the point is, it works.
Nice trade.
And that was actually risky.
Oh, and that looked like he backdashed, but no.
If you don't make the decision to get away, that's it. If you don't make the decision to get away straight away, you're going to get caught by that ultra. And that is six rounds straight now.
Yeah.
6 rounds straight for Infectious. I don't know how is he coming? Like, he just basically...
Gagapar's playing with fear now.
He jumped once, and then he dashed forward once, another SPD, and then he got clapped once. Mm-hmm. And that, all those three things just basically...
And the thing is, you get hurt so bad for doing all of those things, it stops you playing the game that... You know you need to play.
Even Chun-Li, even if Chun-Li does stand heavy kick, which is a very good normal, if he gets hit by the clap, that was a very good option, by the way.
Yeah.
he was going in too hard, so he's like reset the momentum. But even Chun Li with her good stand heavy kick, just getting clapped once can make you want to not do it, because you're taking 400 damage. So he doesn't wake up Ultra. He's not gonna. He might get Ultra again, but Bisons don't really land Ultra. Look at the health difference.
Yeah.
So he's going for the stand jab again just to check him. And he tried for the... There we go. And he tried just then.
Yeah, and that time the lariat did work. So he's on two back-to-back. You've seen the stubbornness there.
Yeah.
That time he was able to use the EX Devil's Reverse to get out because he had burned all of the bar. So that was a good choice. Oh my god, he dashed twice. It wasn't even two quick dashes. Yeah. It was just two... He dashed once, then
the focus dash, just in case a normal came out, and then did Ultra.
Great stuff.
And that is all working because he's scared to press a normal because he's been clapped and taken 400 damage for it. Now he's scared of the dash. So now he's been pressing normals.
Yeah, he's back to pressing normals now. Doesn't want to let him dash in. He's scissoring at max range. He's getting checked with the jab.
He's just doing scissors now.
That jab does chunks as well.
Yeah, his jab does 50 damage. So counter hit is like, what? Quarter more. 16. And the jump, the trade is always in Hugo's favour.
And he gets caught with a classic.
He's scared now. He's scared to press normals.
You don't want to press buttons and get
that is guaranteed. He fell into that.
That was a dominating round. That's like the first dominating round that he's had.
That was probably a missed input, but that's all to do with just the fact that he's scared.
Yeah.
He's probably just mistimed the forward into EX scissors or something like that, but he's just scared. The fear of Hugo.
It's 4-3, I believe.
That's 8 games now.
4-4, so he's squared it all.
How though?
Just like that. This ain't no half hours. This has gone quick, man.
But how has he done that though?
Gagapar's just playing so timid and scared, but he's going in now.
He's trying to switch
out.
He's
actually going in. Yeah. Like, he's not just going back to the zoning. He's going in.
And look, he's scared. Look, you can't hesitate. 320 damage.
Stood up in the corner. Has to get out of the EX.
That gets out regardless. It'll break the armor. But he's scared. Like, he's literally scared to do anything. And Infectious still.
Oh, and again.
Yeah. Look. 320 damage
again.
See,
the thing is, when Infectious smells blood and he knows, that's why
he keeps doing it. Because he knows you're scared.
Yeah.
He knows he's scared, so he's just going to do it. That was also safe to Ultra.
The same way, when Infectious knows something's working.
Yeah, he'll keep doing it.
He'll keep doing it.
Yep.
Until you show them he can't anymore.
So he hardly checked him with any stand jabs. He literally just done normals into meat squasher in
that
round.
Meat squasher.
So now he's looking for the meat squasher. So he's going to be pressing normals. Now you're going to get clapped again.
Now you're going to get clapped.
Yeah.
He's going to try and get into the range to try and buffer something.
Look, he's staying a bit further away now, so he's got more time to react. Infectious still checking with the jab just in case he decides to do a scissor kick.
Yeah. Entirely safe to do.
The range right he's at, range. A scissor kick will take around the same damage as, I think, a stand jab on counter here anyway.
Yeah.
So that trade-off's good. And he's not pressing normals now.
And he's not in range for hard kick anyway at that range where he's standing. Yeah. Nice anti-air. That was a medium kick.
That wasn't even anti, that was pure luck. And look, the jump.
SPD's in the gap.
That's what grapplers do. Safe. Punish. Yeah.
And that was a big slap as well.
Yeah, I think that's 110 damage or 120.
It's like a DP.
120 damage, 120.
It's more than Sagat's DP.
Yeah. And now he's playing patient again.
Yeah, and he's allowed him to dash. He's not throwing out any normals. He doesn't want to get hit. He really doesn't want to get hit.
And look, the one time.
Oh, and he doesn't convert.
That's fine. Why is it the one time I do anything?
Yeah.
I can count it. Like.
And that's done more mental damage than
anything.
The whole combo would have done if it had landed. Like, just doesn't time the EX Lariat.
Yep.
Now he's jumping. Dashing
up. Time's wasting, so he's got to do something.
He's dead now. He's dead now.
So this is the first round Gagapur gets. And this is because Infectious just had to get that round. He really wanted that round. They have to win by two games, by the way. You can't win by one
game.
That's
right. So this isn't the deciding game. It's as I said at the start, it's a by two.
I tried to move the mouse on the screen. You have to win by two games. So look, he just got counter hit for doing scissors. Now what is in your head? That's 450 damage, by the way, guys. 450 damage. And he gets a throw. Basically, this round is basically over. Gets another throw. Going for EX Lariat, gets another throw. And then he teleports to try and bait him. Infectious being infectious, just stay patient, yeah.
That was cheeky.
Checks in with a stand jab. That's a very good option now. Look, it's a very good option. What? You can't dash.
Yeah.
You can't do scissors.
Into
the
it.
The trade into
very yeah. easy to just.
Yeah, the trade into heavy, the trade with heavy kick. It's fine. It's you 200 can take
damage
that.
For those four.
Yeah.
That's like a B&B for.
Yeah. He's just mashing jab. So he's 5-4 up now.
Questionable decisions there from Gagapa. Like, why would you dash forward?
Because he needed to win. He needed to win there.
Yeah, but.
He was trying to dash forward and throw, maybe trying to surprise him. Yeah. But that he's checking him. He's been checking him,
he's
the,
been
whole,
checking him
the whole
time.
Set. Been
got
checking
him killed.
Him.
So.
And look,
oh,
the
and
one time. Free. Oh,
Gagapa's got to be thinking, like, what's wrong with my luck?
Yeah.
Oh, nice backdash that time. He had to.
Yep.
Had
neutral
to
stance.
There.
That is also scary. Why are you standing in neutral, shaking your head?
Hagajin style.
Literally, the one, like, it's now. Getting to the point where it looks like Infectious is psychic.
Yeah.
Because the one time this guy is trying to do something.
The one time he presses a button.
He gets clapped.
The clap's
slow,
already out. The clap's
slow
already
roll.
Out.
Yeah. He's clapping and you're doing something. Look, he can't. He's jumping for free now. He's not even doing heavy kick.
Heavy kick anti-air, which is easy.
Yes. He jumped twice for free because he's scared.
Yeah. Now you're blocking claps again. You don't want to be there blocking. He wants to stay at that range forever.
Yep. The range, just where you can scissors.
That was
free.
A risky scissors as well, because on block that would have been punishable.
And he's doing the scissors. He's playing the right game right now.
Yeah, nicely spaced. But again, he goes back to the light punch and checking.
Checking just in case. And he knows what can happen.
Yeah, that time he's ready. It's just a bit too far
That's
away.
The range. That's why he's at the range, so he can be ready.
Dude, I saw Valmaster punish that with throw.
Yep.
Like, that's the bravest... You're the bravest man on the planet.
And he got an SPD at the 10-second mark.
I think he loses this round.
He gets hit. No, he doesn't lose it. I don't think he loses it.
Oh, the jab.
There
yeah,
you go.
He does.
Oh, he just about loses
yeah,
it.
He lost it.
Gagapa making actual movements. Infectious JPEG still. And he actually gets a round.
He's
so now he's up. He's got a chance to make it 5-5.
He needs to bring this back because this is match game for Infectious. 5 straight. Nice focus. Again, you've seen the max range focus backdash. He correctly identified the range though that he would be too far out to SPD.
No, because the last few games it whiffed.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
He knew this time that it wouldn't work. And Gagapa content to play this game. And look, the checking. Gagapa hasn't got life lead, but
he's
checking
he's,
again.
He's basically not
jab.
Allowing Gagapa to do anything. If Gagapa's going to play at that range, it's going to be risky for you to throw out scissors because you're. If you trade, it's going to be the one hit. I've got more health than you. And exactly, he's identified that Gagapa doesn't want to do anything.
He's checked him.
Now it's time for the meat squasher because you're just looking for that jab to come out. You're scared of claps.
Oh, if you use the splash there. So Gagapa's now cornered him. This is where you want to be. He'll still check you with the jab, but this is a lot better for Gagapa now. He can control his face
he's
now.
Got more, he's got more... more space,
yeah, more
stage
space
to work with.
Yeah,
he can keep backing away and maintaining that spacing if he needs to.
And Infectious is being calm, and that reaches. No, that's
what?
Reaches. Infectious
he
knows.
He off the ground.
No, he was just walking back, but Infectious just knows the range. That's how far the range is as well. Hit him with it, safe. No option select this time, and checks him.
150.
Yep, easy 150 damage. And now it's time up. Don't do anything.
Just keep blocking. You can take them throws, take that, yeah.
Techs it.
Nice tech.
But he can't do it. Even if he's walking forward, what's Bison going to do?
Take the throw again.
That's it.
And we are at match point for Infectious
set
after being
point.
4-0 down. And he's got full super as well.
Yeah, that's just long. Literally one hit can just be 500 damage.
Yeah.
Easy. And he doesn't need bar to do near 400 damage. And look, the jumps. 2 jumps.
Yeah.
No anti-air.
I mean,
he's
really,
not even looking.
Really, what this is highlighting is what you should not do against Hugo, more than what a Hugo can do, because Gagapa's just stopped doing all the things that worked.
And he gets
and
the
he
super.
And he gets the jump in that time, into the super, into
and
the
he tries
back
to get
breaker.
The, he tries
no,
to get it, he misses
get it.
It. That would be
he tried to get the late one, so
which does like an extra 95 damage. That focus does hit the stand heavy kick as well, but he hasn't shown that once at all in the set.
Gagapa's like scissoring after, or puts himself in the corner, scissoring.
Nice link.
Scissoring after the lights come out.
Nice, but he could have gone into ultra there.
Had to burn the bar, yeah. Drops the combo.
He should have gone straight into ultra because that would have made it a lot more even. But he's evened it up a little bit, but there's 35 seconds on the clock.
So he's extended the range a little bit, the spacing, and now he's gone back in.
And that stand heavy
kick was fortunate because they came out exactly the same time. In another universe, that could have been something else entirely. Three dashes. Yeah, he's playing a much more extended range.
Oh my god! And he hits him, KO.
And he takes it.
And that is all because.
From 4-0 down, you know.
Yeah, that is all because you're scared.
He was terrified.
To press buttons.
Terrified.
And then when you're scared to press buttons, you get grabbed. And then you start pressing buttons again.
He stopped anti-airing.
Yep, he couldn't even anti-air with one button. Yeah. His stand heavy kick's 4 frames, 5 frames? What is it, five?
I think it's five.
He
won 8 rounds in a row. And was 4-0 up, ready to walk into the final five of Kakatop.
He just wreaked havoc in that final
five. So Infectious, they're showing, you know, really great awareness of his opponent's psychology.
Yep.
Identifying what he was scared of.
Yep.
Identifying all of that. What options were the best options to use? At that time, when he knows what Gagapa's afraid to do, what does that allow me to get away with doing?
He's definitely a long set type player.
Definitely. If you're going to play stubborn, if you're going to play by the book, if you're going to play by exactly what works in training mode, 2 out of 3s, not for you.
Yeah.
Like, it's definitely not for you. If you're like them studious sort of players, 2 out of 3s, not for you.
He's definitely a long set cap. But I would like to see with Infectious just that, especially for 2 out of 3, just this, because his play is like, if he gets a top 8, his play is perfect.
Yeah.
The way he plays is perfect. But for 2 out of 3, safe is good. I've told him stuff like, everybody knows Infectious can hit claps. Yeah. So hit the clap into the EX clap, into the clap, to the clap, into the jab, into the reset.
Yeah.
Like, Ultra Frog against the wall or something.
Because that's all
your health gone.
Yeah.
And everyone knows you can hit the claps.
I would like to see him use Ultra 2 in a few matchups as well, because he lives and dies by Ultra 1.
And that's
and
all.
And you get nice damage off that Ultra Throw, you know?
Yeah, no. For the Ultra 2, is literally just because he doesn't want you to... He wants to stop you from doing meaties. So you can only get damage from zoning him. Only. And to get damage only from zoning him as Hugo, it's just long.
That's a fair shout.
It just feels so long.
It's a fair shot.
But that's literally what he said. He said, like...
And I suppose the longer it is, the longer that takes, the more patient he can be, and he can wait for his opening, I guess.
If your zoning doesn't do enough damage, significant damage to hurt him, then you're going to lose. Because you can't go in and do a meaty, because he'll just do the ultra. He'll do it. So even you bait it, and even if you bait, he'll do it again.
Yeah.
And then if you get hit by the ultra, that's all that health gone, and now you're scared to go in because he's... done stuff like that, and you have to just deal with trying to get damage another way.
You got
to
get that knockdown again as well, anyway,
or something like that to get damage.
Yeah,
and then you know normals aren't the best thing against Hugo because the clap, like
you're risking counter hits. Exactly.
You're risking getting counter hit with the clap, so he's kind of locking you in your own head.
Mm.
But you have to be stubborn.
And you saw exactly what happened.
Yeah, he wasn't stubborn. Gagapo wasn't stubborn.
No,
you're not.
But
supposed
he got
to
locked inside his own head.
Yeah, you're not supposed to stop what made
cabin fever.
What won you 4 games?
Yeah,
you're not ever supposed to stop what won you 4 games. Well, you got shook. Like,
you only have to win one.
Yeah,
like
one game with claps.
But Gagapa is a very, very good player. Like, I don't want to take anything away from him. We're not showing this video just to like show up Gagapa, because
nobody's been
I said before this tournament, like, I rate Gagapa as possibly the best Bison in the world.
Easy, man. I think that's easy. I don't think there's it.
But you're seeing that mental frailty that.
But I think there's long sets with characters, but nobody's had a long set with Hugo. Nobody.
Mm.
Like you haven't felt making one mistake. You haven't even made a mistake. You just happened to time your normal
well,
at the same
like,
time as his.
2 out of 3 is long enough because, like you said, when you play against Infectious, you're only getting damage in zoning. Yeah. It feels like a 1st of 3 lasts an hour.
Seriously.
Against Hugo.
It's long.
In the 1st of 5, which turned into a 1st of 6, like, how many scissors did he have to do? Like, every time you're risking your life.
Getting like 10 damage. Yeah.
Every time you're risking your life.
Yeah, you get like 10 damage doing a scissor on block. It's not scary.
Yeah.
But it's like, the thing is, he's not, you're not doing anything wrong by pressing a normal.
Yeah.
it just happened that he just happened to time his clap.
Like you said, there was a point in there where it looked like
he was psychic.
He was psychic.
Yeah.
Because I'm down back in. I'm not doing anything. I'm down back in. Three seconds.
He tried to do a scissors.
4 seconds. Yeah. Nothing. 5 seconds. All right, cool. He's walking forward. No. Sorry.
Try to do scissors. You get clapped. Counter hit.
Sorry.
Counter hit clap. He didn't even hit the counter hit combo. He can do heavy clap, heavy clap, medium clap. Yeah. He didn't do that. He just did heavy clap into the normal sequence down. He could have done heavy clap, medium clap, EX clap, like just 1,000 claps. That's like 500 damage, right? Nah, this is ridiculous.
Crazy stuff. What a great set. And we're going to end it on there. I hope you guys enjoyed that.
We love
to give you an insight into what's going on here in Europe if you guys are tuned in from around the world. We've got a big event this weekend. I know you guys are going to be watching Defend the North in North America. That's going to be on late night for us here in the UK. But when you wake up early in the morning, on the weekend, Milan. You guys need to be tuning into Milan Games Week, premier event on the Capcom Pro Tour. Let me run through some of the players that are going to be there. Of course, from Europe, you're going to have Ryan Hart, you're going to have Luffy, Valmaster. Is Infectious in Milan?
Infectious must be in Milan.
Pro Flukes there. Who else is in Milan?
We got Affy in Milan.
Affy. I'm still the daddy out there. And RMZ, of course. Shout out to RMZ.
Myself, Pax is there.
And Pax will be there. And, of course, traveling internationally, we've got Haitani, we've got Shiro, we've got Tompi, we've got Fudo, we've got Zian, Gonzalez.
Kindevu. RB.
And mate, possibly some others as well.
K-Brad.
K-Brad is flying all the way out to get his butt whipped and sent back to America as well. So I know you're going to want to watch that.
Bruh.
Saturday and Sunday.
Bruh.
Morning time for you guys on the East Coast. Check it out. Is that going to be on Capcom Fighters? I'd imagine it is.
I believe so. It's the premiere.
Premieres usually take precedence on Capcom Fighters. I'm going to be there with Zaid Ramsey on commentary, so make sure you tune in. Take care. We've been Winner Stays On Second Sessions. Thank you very much, Pax, for joining us. Always a pleasure. We'll be back next Tuesday night, same time. If you enjoyed the show, watch back on the Twitch if you're a subscriber, or you can wait a couple of days and it'll be up on the YouTube channel, youtube.com/CapcomFighters. Thank you very much to Unequaled Media for the stream solution. As always, brilliant stuff from you guys. And take care, everyone in the chat.
So I do. I stab and I throw rocks.
See
I don't clap.
You next week.